Good morning to our participants and welcome to our information session. And just stand by and we will begin shortly in just 7 minutes. So thank you so much for coming.
Traffic is making me sick. Boy, I can't wait to have you near. Gotta hurry, hurry, hurry now. Quick, quick, quick. Just step on the gas, 'cause I don't wanna miss this. This opportunity will only come once in my life. My life. Gotta hurry, hurry, hurry now. Quick, quick, quick. Just step on the gas, 'cause I don't wanna miss this. See what you're bringing me, boy, it's priceless. I gotta be out of my mind not to try this. Through strength I found love. In time I found myself in happiness with you. Through strength I found love. In time I found myself in happiness with you. You can give to me, I can feel it when you're holding me close. You're like one of the world wonders. I know I'm going under. Come see that I'm ready for this. And you're so good for me. You're my true joy. You make me want to say creeping up like tick tock. I'm trying to keep you in my head, but if not, we'll just keep running from tomorrow with our lips locked. Yeah, you got me begging, begging, baby, please don't go. If I wake up tomorrow, will you still be here? I don't know if you feel the way I do. If you leave, I'm gonna find you. Baby, please.
please don't go.
Okay, good morning to everyone. Good morning to our, of course, the participants and of course our panelists, and welcome to our 2022 info session. So this is going to be our first leg for the year. And before we officially begin our program, let us first put ourselves in the presence of the Lord and commit ourselves to a prayer. Dear Father, we thank you for everyone gathered here now. Thank you that you know each of us by name and have caused us to walk with you. We say that we are dependent on you and our trust is in you only. As we surrender ourselves in adoration, we welcome you amongst us today and celebrate the gift of life that you have lavished upon each of us. We ask that you would open our ears so that we may hear your voice. Open our minds so that we may receive your eternal wisdom. Open our spirits so that we may know your leading guidance. In our hearts so that we may receive your wonderful love. Lord, we thank you for the speakers and facilitators. We pray that you would give them inspiration, fill them with courage, and give them peace. We ask all these in the glorious name of Jesus. Okay, hello, good morning to everyone, good morning partner, and good morning to our participants, and of course panelists. My name is Wendell Rocky. I am the creative writer of the Asian Institute of Journalism and Communication, and with me here today is my partner, Ms. Christine. Kindly introduce yourself to our participants.
Again, good morning to all the participants, President Olive, Dr. Paz, Ms. Olive, Mr. Eugene, and everyone who are here today. Welcome, everyone. Thank you for joining us for today's info session. My name is Christine, and I am the registrar and librarian at AIJC. I hope everyone is excited.
Oo naman, Ms. Dean, for sure naman lahat ng participants natin ngayon ay looking forward to be part of AIJC and of course know what's in store for them just by joining this info session. And I'm For sure, marami silang matututunan sa event natin today. And I'm really hoping that by the end of this info session, ay talagang we were able to encourage them to enroll and be part of our very loving and fun community. And such a wonderful Wednesday morning today, right? Kahit na medyo maulan, medyo hindi kagandahan ng panahon lately. Just by surviving every day, it's just a wonderful blessing from Lord, no? Of course. Ikaw ba, Miss Tim, kumusta ang Wednesday morning ko?
Actually, I am not feeling well today, but I am so excited, Mr. Wendell, for our event today.
Nako, kahapon lang din, medyo nag-suffer din ako sa you know, severe dizziness. Pero ngayon, I'm really okay naman na. So, sana lahat din ng participants natin ay okay. And sana mas pangalagaan natin ang health natin, especially these days na hindi masyadong kagandahan at nagsusulputan ng iba't ibang sakit bukod sa COVID. Okay, yes. So anyways, ano ba tong AIJC info session na to? What's in it for our participants? Why do they have to you know, to go and see this webinar for themselves? So, ito ang Asian Institute of Journalism and Communication. It's a 40-year-old higher education institution that offers two master's programs. We have MA in Communication and MA in Journalism. And of course, this information session is being held to encourage our government officials, particularly those who are involved in communication on a daily basis, to bolster their competencies as information and public relations officers through AIJC's diverse array of course offerings and other programs, which will be further discussed later on the BAMIS team.
Yes. So to further give you an insight of what AIJC is all about, let us watch an audio video presentation of our AIJC alumni and PDP training participants and how AIJC has changed their lives.
Sir Eugene, roll VTR.
Opportunities,
competencies,
development,
growth.
Flexible.
Life-changing.
Attending graduate school has always been my plan, but the need to attend one felt stronger when I was 2 or 3 years into my work as a journalist for an alternative online news.
I decided to pursue graduate studies, not just for personal and professional growth, but also because I believe that by pursuing a graduate degree program, I would be able to expand my horizon and my opportunities.
I was in my late 20s when I became part of the graduate school program of the Asian Institute of Journalism and Communication.
What prompted me to enroll in AIJC was the need na yung magkaroon ng structure yung ginagawa naming video.
Early on, I already had an idea of AIJC having a balanced take on theoretical and pragmatic approaches.
I've learned about AIJC from my colleagues at work. I've heard some pretty good feedback from them. Seeing how they walk the talk made me pick AIJC as my first ever training center since I joined the DENL.
We were into science communication, but I kept reflecting these questions. Did we communicate enough to farmers? Motivated me to enroll in the graduate program of AIJC.
AIJC was really a home for me for several years. There was a robust collegial atmosphere.
In many ways, AIJC helped me in my career. Apart from the things that I have learned in school, I have also gained friends along the way.
Nakatulong yung training na yon para punuan yung need ko kung paano makakapagkwento ng mas maayos at mas maintindihan ng viewer yung gusto namin iparating.
So because of AIJC, I was recommended for a communication post at UNICEF. And that led me to over 20 years of professional work in communication for development.
AIJC is one of the few research-based organizations working collaboratively within the communication industry to creating programs and services that are grounded and attuned to both the analog and digital world, promoting communication for development.
It was that kind of commitment that really struck me as a communication student, that they were willing to go out of their way to help young communication students like me back then.
The graduate program of AIJC has mentored me to improve my competencies in communication research, communication and development programming and management.
My most memorable experiences at AIJC would include our field work in the different communities where we conducted community immersion and at the same time conducted data gathering. I see that AIJC will continue to be a relevant institution which I hope will continue to expand its horizons as it offers learning via distance mode.
As such, even before this so-called new normal, the institution has already been offering off-campus classes, online learning, and short courses and training.
In spite of the challenges brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic, AIJC was quick to offer custom-fit training modules.
The training contributed to my growth, equipping me with the right skill.
My long stay in AIJC instilled in me a strong appreciation of a balanced take on theory and practice. This has stayed with me, and I apply it as an academician and a professor in communication.
It is a community that is very much grounded on the realities and the struggles of journalists and communications experts who are battling against disinformation and false narratives and against all forms of curtailment to our rights to freedom of expression and of the press.
I believe that the institution remains relevant and responsive to the changing needs of society.
I can highly recommend AIJC's trainings dahil nga karamihan sa kanilang trainers ay working professional and are considered experts in their field.
AIJC must continue educating, producing, and mentoring communicators.
So yes, AIJC is a big part of my life.
Padayon at patuloy po tayo sa paglaban para sa katotohanan.
There you have it. Thank you so much for that very insightful and inspirational video. Now, grabe, no? So Asian Institute and Journalism and Communication, it's really a well-rounded and holistic institution. No, talaga naman, so nakita natin na we have stakeholders from various departments, from different fields, hindi lamang. Kasi, di ba, sometimes when we think of communication, we're just confined with the thought na, oh, it's just journalism and communication. But no, here in AIJC, we're able to produce stalwarts and academicians and partners that, you know, nasa iba't ibang klase ng field. So we have Dr. Lantikan, just like what we've seen in the video from the science department, no, partner, and we have stakeholders from the DENR. Of course, we have Sir Nilo Yakat, our statistician, na love ng students natin. So hopefully, our participants, pag nag-enroll kayo, no, ma-meet nyo yung ating mga butihing at matatalino at magagaling na mga professors. So ayun, partner, no, ano nga ba ang AIJC? So hindi na natin ito patatagalin. Introduce na natin ang pinakamamahal natin. Love natin tong speaker na to, and lahat ng participants natin pag nag-enroll sila. For sure, mamimit nila to. Very wonderful person. Okay, so let's introduce Ms. Team.
Okay. Dr. Paz H. Diaz is the Vice President for Academic Affairs and Acting Dean of the Graduate School of the Asian Institute of Journalism and Communication. She has traveled as consultant for over 40 years, designing training programs and conducting sessions on communication, entrepreneurship, and community development in local communities, as well as in developing countries in Asia and Africa. Her academic career at AIJC began in 2016, and has since flourished until today. Let us all welcome Dr. Paz H. Diaz.
Good morning, Dr. Paz. Happy Wednesday.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Wendell and team.
Good morning.
Thank you for the nice introduction. Can I be heard?
Yes.
Yes, loud and clear. Loud and clear, Dr. Paz.
Okay, thank you. So let's just begin. Ang una kong gagawin is give a background and the history of AIJC. Pagkatapos, something about the courses that we offer. Okay, we opened our doors, ang tagal na, 1980. Okay, sa ano pa, sa Journal Building sa Port Area, Manila. Next, please. Yes, ito mga stalwarts, ito mga board of trustees nung nag-umpisa. We have Dr. Salvador Lopez, our veteran journalist Jose Luna Castro. Siguro mga lolo at lola niyo ang nakakatanda dyan, or kayo din kung nag-aaral kayo sa history. And of course, up to now, we have our current President Emeritus, Dr. Florangel Rosario Braid. Ito pa yung iba, si Dr. Tintin Doromal. Some of them have passed on, but their memory lives, you know, because sila ang, anong tawag dyan, ang standard bearers ng communication and journalism throughout the country. Next, please. Today, we have with our Board of Trustees still Dr. Braid. But our chairman now is Mr. Mel V. Velarde, who also owns Now Corporation. Mr. William Torres is still here with us. Dr. Florangel Braid, our President Emeritus, as I said. Our President who will speak with you later is Ma'am Olive M. Villafuerte. And our other, are there listed. Okay. Up to now, we have Francis Manglapus and Dr. Ramon Artuas. Okay. So AIJC is founded on the philosophy that communication is a vital resource to be used to advance the common good. Okay, and so AIJC has three big departments, the graduate programs, and then the research policy and advocacy department, and then the professional development program. Magkakahiwalay, pero all for the same aim, to advance the common good. Next, please. So our graduate programs challenges traditional concept of graduate education because we have innovative courses, learning approaches, and teaching methods. We offer Master of Arts in Communication, Master of Arts in Journalism, and lately, the Master of Communication major in Public Relations, PR, and Corporate Communication. Kaka-approve ng CHED itong aming third MA program. Next, please. Okay. What we do, we integrate the research outputs in classroom as case studies. We have innovative and pioneering courses, as we said. We have academics and practitioners, mostly practitioners talaga sila in the field as faculty members. And then our students get involved in policy and action research. And we do mixed mode of delivery, although lately it has been really mostly online because of the COVID-19. Next, please. So the MA in Communication, the study and practice of communication aims to enhance innovative, creative, and critical thinking, upgrade competencies in communication planning and management, communication policy analysis, education and training, and research and development, and promote adherence to ethical standards and responsibility. So yung sa inyo na gustong mag-MA in Com, yan ang mangyayari sa inyo. Okay, next please. Sa MA in Journalism naman, I hope meron ding sa inyo mag-enroll sa MA in Journalism kasi napakaganda rin ito. Development of professional journalism competencies or practical skills. So marami siyang practical skills. Knowledge and skills in news development, identification and analysis of current journalism issues, study and evaluation of journalism practices, and integration of ICT in news development and newsroom management. Yung mga social media, yung mga modern platforms. Yan, aralin ninyo lahat yan. Next, please. Ngayon, ang maganda, it's ladderized. Yung pareho sila, yung dalawang programs. In other words, pag natapos ka ng 15 units na required, meron ka na kaagad certificate in communication. So, awardan ka na namin yan. So, meron ka ng may pagmamalaki or mailalagay sa mo sa table. Pagkatapos, that one, 15 plus 12 units na ulit, graduate diploma ka na in communication or graduate diploma in journalism. So, dalawa na. Meron ka ng dalawang certificate. Pagkatapos niyan, you will do your com research, tapos methods and statistics applied to communication, 6 units yon. Tapos magko-compre ka, walang kawala sa compre. Kailangan papasa ka muna sa compre. And then, thesis writing na or special project, later on, if you're enrolled, makikita mo na hindi lang thesis ang pwede, pwede rin special project, tsaka actually ngayon, pwede rin case study. 6 units required. Pag natapos mo yan, MA ka na talaga. MA ang iyong degree. Ang iyong degree and ang iyong diploma. So, tatlo ang marireceive mo na parchment paper galing sa amin. Signed by our president. Yung pangatlo, merong SO galing sa CHED. So, tunay na graduate ka na kasi may serial order ang CHED. Okay, next please. Etong kompre naman, hindi naman siya nakakatakot. Okay? Kailangan lang, you have to take it. Puro siya practical questions. Okay? So, you worry about it pag nakatapos ka na ng 30 units. Okay, next please. Ngayon, ang aming academic calendar, we will be on enrollment break mula August 1 to 13. So, enroll na kayo. Tapos, ang first trimester will begin August 15 hanggang November 2. Tapos, enrollment break ulit, November 2 to December 4. Tapos, second trimester, December 5 to March 18, 2023 na yan. Pero merong Christmas break. Maiksi lang ang Christmas break kasi eskwela. Kahit eskwela tayo, hindi tayo kasing tulad ng undergrad na 2 weeks yata ang Christmas break. Then we continue with our enrollment. And then, third trimester, April 3 to July 15, merong Holy Week break, April 6 to April 9. Pero July 15, tapos na ang And some will graduate also on July 15, 2023. Okay, next please. So, meron din kaming tinatawag na professional development program. Ito naman ay mga short courses, short term, non-degree. 2 days, 3 days, ganyan. Merong corporate comm planning, business comm, working with mass media, e-learning, technical and business writing, news and feature writing. So, mga short term, social media management, short term. No? Wendell, nag-lecture ka na ba dyan?
Dapat hindi pa po, Dr. Paz. Parang last year pa natin pinag-uusapan to. Pero sige, I'll decide this year.
Oo. Kasi yan, sa social media management, galing-galing mo.
Sakto, I'm also handling the social media across all brands of our company. So, nga, Dr. Paz, no? Baka pwede kong itry na.
Oo. Maganda ang honorario. Okay, next please.
Very exciting and enticing. Okay, Dr. Pascual.
Okay. We also have competency-based training areas, data analytics, risk communication, oral presentation and public speaking, media relations, photojournalism, script writing for video documentaries, we offer that. And ang aming usual audience, mga government agencies, NGOs, international orgs, and business and industry, multilateral and bilateral agencies. Yan, usually UNESCO, UN, yan. Nagpapadala sila ng participants sa atin. Okay, next please. Ang mandate natin to deliver the learning intervention that companies need so that communicators can better articulate the corporate mission in the 21st century environment. Ito yung ng aming short-term na PDP, Professional Development Programs. Nandun yata ako sa likod dyan. Okay. Pero before ano yan, before COVID, kaya walang mga masks ang mga...
Busy ka dyan, Dr. Paz, nag-check ng mga sagot ng students. Nasa background. Nag-check ng ginagawa.
Uh-oh. Okay, next please. Ayan. Training provider of choice kasi solid record in organizing, managing, documenting, and evaluating training programs on communication and related fields. Develops training designs that are needs and competency based and learner centered. Okay, so we do a lot of training needs analysis before we develop the program. Next, please. We also provide experiential, hands-on, participatory, and interactive sessions to keep the participants engaged and receptive to new info. And then promotes interdisciplinary or multidisciplinary approach to bring social psychological perspective to studying problems and finding solutions. Yan yata for photojournalism class ata yan with Jimmy Domingo. Okay, next.
Yes, sakto. Si Sir Jimmy, no, Dr. Paz, no, ngayon we are offering photojournalism with Sir Jimmy. So, very timely talaga.
Mm-hmm. Multi-awarded photojournalist. Okay. Our modes, dun sa PDP, merong public, merong in-house, kung gusto ng isang organization, like DOLE, DOLE, Labor and Employment Department, papagawa sila, exclusive para sa kanila. Or self-paced, meron kaming ano, individual modules that can be completed within 30 days from day one. Okay, next please. Online, meron din kami now, online PDP courses. And I think, yeah, nag-ano na kami, nag-face-to-face na nung ano sa Tagaytay last week. Nag-umpisa na face-to-face. Pero we were doing online all the time during the COVID.
So meaning to say, Dr. Paz, hybrid pa rin tayo, no?
Oo, yeah. Okay, next please. Yan ang mga clients namin. Makita nyo, pati UCPB, pati BPI. Okay, next please. Ito mga sinasabi ng participants. Thank you for the opportunity given to us. It was enjoyable sort of back to basic. Much needed review of basic tools in grammar and style. Siyempre kasi pag grammar and writing, ano yan, mostly review yan. Yung mga naaral na nung high school tsaka college.
Yes, okay. Yes. I agree.
Okay, next please.
Okay, so ito naman, Dr. Paz, we move on to the research policy and advocacy. So ako rin ay medyo naka-work na rin dyan, of course, with studies. So go ahead, Dr. Paz.
Good. Ano ito? Ito ang aming mga famous researchers to generate new knowledge and innovations that enrich development programs and provide policy options to government and the private sector. Ano sila? Sila ang nagagawa ng mga questionnaire at napakonduct ng research. Okay, next please. Ayan, advocating communication policies. They do things like policy framework for the communication sector, national comm policy consultation series, research study on policies on information access and transparency, and national consultation on media and information literacy, MIL, policies and strategies in the Philippines. So sila naman ang taga-acquire ng ganyang knowledge. Next, please. They also promote environmental sustainability projects. They did work with the DABFAR, public awareness campaign of the Philippine Ozone Desk, communication for sustainable livelihoods and food security, editorial assistance, in the application of communication for development approaches, DNR IEC Model and System, DNR World Bank Rural Power Project Communication Investment Programs. So we also help with environmental sustainability. Next, please. Ayan. Promoting free and responsible journalism. Very active din ang ating RPA dyan. Safeguarding yes. press freedom. Yan, dami mo na cover dyan, di ba, Wendell?
Last year, Dr. Paz, we've worked with EU. Yan, so gumawa kami ng campaign for them. We also worked with Labor Department, both local and international. So very hands-on talaga research policy and advocacy in terms of research. So ayun. Malalaman niya ng participants natin kapag nag-enroll talaga sila, no, Dr. Paz? Experience
lalo
nila.
Lalo yung ano, integrating safety in journalism.
Yes, most importantly, yan talaga ang highlight ng RPA, I believe, the safeguarding press freedom in the Philippines. Very important yan. Lalo na ngayon na tinatag ang ating... Okay, I won't go deep into that, but yeah. Go ahead, Dr. Paz.
Next, please. Okay, communicating peace and development. Ito naman, ano? Instead of just raising your arms, you do peace and development. So research studies and forums with Christians and Muslims. Nakagawa ako ng isa dyan for Christians and Muslims. Communication program for the Sharia court. And website on Muslim Mindanao for journalists and other communicators. Okay, next please. Tapos, rule of law and justice reform. We did work with the justicia natin, uncovering the courts, media training, and monitoring the judiciary. Okay, so ang media ang nagmo-monitor sa judiciary. Access to justice for the poor project, communication program for court annexed mediation, communication plan for the access to justice network, enhancing communication between the judiciary and the citizenry, which is quite important. Supporting governance in justice sector reform. Okay, next please. ICT for development, syempre, enhances ICT capacities of multi-stakeholders to improve the quality of life of people and communities. Okay, next please. Ito mga clients ng RPA, mula Office of the President hanggang mga GOs and NGOs, mula multilateral agencies such as the World Bank, hanggang mga foundations like Konrad Adenauer Stiftung, Friedrich Ebert Stiftung, and other such agencies. Next, please. Ayan. So our distinctiveness, pioneering, and innovative courses. I think nabanggit ko na yan. Next, please. Yung cross-cultural com, I handle that always. Library and repository. Ayan. Ano yan? Mm-hmm. Expertise ni Team.
Ayan. So maybe Miss Team can help with the explanation of library and repository, no? Miss Team, our librarian and registrar.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, so AIJC has one of the most comprehensive library collections in the field of communication in the country. The AIJC library is a repository of about 5,000 volumes and materials in various media formats, including a vertical file of important documents and rare materials on communication and development. It uses the library, which is Koha Library System, a fully featured learning management system. So sa AIJC, we are using Koha Library System to organize the all materials in the library. So kung meron po kayong mga needed documents or books, I am here to guide and support you and find you the best material.
Nakahanap siya ng material para kay Dr. ano, Cuenco, di ba? Yung hindi mahanap.
Yes.
Nahanap ni Tina.
Yes, nice. And also, are they, ano na ba, is it available na ba for face-to-face borrowing of books or kung mahihirap sila, pwede na ba yun, Dr. Paz, Miss Tina?
aayusin pa ang library mabuti. The fog siguro.
Okay.
To make it really
accessible talaga.
Accessible, viable. Yes. Pero right now, by email, no? Team, pwede ka?
Yes, po. Yes, po. Pwede po silang mag-send ng email kapag may kailangan po silang books. And then, I can go to the library naman po.
Oo. And then, you can also send mga, references na online references.
Yes, Dr. Paz.
Okay, very good. Next, please. Ito naman, print and electronic publications, K-team pa rin yan. Marami tayong publications naka-lodge sa library. May mga electronic journals, merong print, no? Hard copies, which Tin also supervises.
Yes, Dr. Paz.
Okay, thank you. Next, please. So, ito na. Start working with AIJC as a partner to offer you access to policy and action research on communication and journalism, linkage with international and national networks in communication and mass media, participation in innovative and pioneering ICT programs and projects. So join us, no, and you will get access to all of that. Next,
and you know, Dr. Paz, if I may just add, no, in terms of, since we're talking about partnership na rin, so again, nabanggit na siya kanina, we just recently partnered with Public Relations Society of the Philippines, and we now just launched, so very exciting to, so na-launch na namin ang program na Master in Communication, Major in Public Relation, and corporate communication. Ayan, medyo mahaba siya. Pero kaka-launch lang namin, guys, so we can send you details about that as well. So, ayan. Go, Dr. Paswell.
Very good. Okay. I think that's the end of the PowerPoint. Yeah, this is come on, our applicants. Ayan. All we need is a bachelor's degree, preferably in journalism or communication, pero kung wala ka niyan, okay pa din. Kung nagkaroon ka ng work and experience in com-related jobs, or kung science ang natapos mo, meron kang isa o dalawang subject na parang to introduce you into journalism. Pero i-evaluate ka namin eh. Our president will interview you with me also. Kung feel namin na kaya mo, go ka na kaagad into the program itself. So, ayan. Yung admission test and interview, huwag kayong matatakot sa admission test. Ano yan? Puro practical questions yan. Tapos yun, na yung required documents na, yung original transcript of records, two letters of recommendation, tsaka yung magandang picture mo, at saka CV. Yan. Okay. I think that's the last. Wendell, Q&A. Okay.
So ayan, before our before tayo mag-move sa touch points, no, so sige, flash lang natin sa screen. Again, good morning to our participants who just came in. So we have a pretty good number today. I'm just really happy to see those numbers who attended today, no. So maraming salamat, and for sure marami kayong natutunan, and I really hope you guys do. So as you can see, we have the Q&A button here, so you can just shoot your question directly. Kung may mga question kayo regarding our GS program, the short courses, and the online courses that we offer sa PDP, sa research and policy and advocacy units natin. So just go ahead, guys, and shoot your questions. We are welcoming all of those. So again, thank you so much, Dr. Paz, for those very insightful and very knowledgeable take on our programs. So I'm just really happy that until this point, naka-work ko pa rin kayo. So sana ay...
malapit ako.
sana ma-experience din ng ating enrollees yan. Oh, I'm claiming na, guys, sana you will enroll na. Okay, so Dr. Paz, we have here a question.
Okay,
so from someone, so how much is the estimated tuition fee per sem for MA in Bonn?
Ayan. Tin. Labas.
Yun.
Schedule.
Okay.
Ayan. Pwede ba yung lakihan ng konti naman? Ayan. Salamat, Tin. Kung cash ang ibabayad mo at isang course lang ang i-enroll mo, 4,000 lang ang isang course. 4,484.18. So parang 4,500. Pero merong miscellaneous na dapat kang bayaran. Kasi yan yung use ng library, pang distance mode na ano to, platform, ano pa ba. Maraming pumapasok dyan sa miscellaneous. So in fact, mas malaki siya sa 3 units, no? 6,000 something siya. Ngayon, kung mag-i-installment ka naman, bakit ba ako nag-i-explain? Hindi ba dapat si Tim? Tim, pwede mo
ma-explain. Oh, Miss Tim, can you expound the... Could you expound, please, the tuition requirements?
Tsaka yung where they will send their ano. Sige, go.
Okay po. So, explain ko lang po, Dr. Paz, muna yung process, no? Bago po tayo pumunta dito para mas malinaw po sa kanila. So, okay. First po, Dr. Paz, they need to send a... Okay.
Audience. Okay.
Okay po. So, ito na lang po yung i-discuss ko or mas mabuti po siguro na i-discuss ko na rin po yung sa admission form from the various part. Okay po. Okay po. So, first, of course, they need to send email to gs@aijc.com and then we will send you the invitation letter that contains the courses offered, the fees, and the scheduled day, time, and the graduate school application for admission form in our MS forms. And then the next step is contact us for the schedule of your entrance exam, essay, and interview. So the fee is 1,050. So our bank account is UPI Family Savings Bank. So account number is 5573-2971-58. So isasend ko naman po ito sa inyo once na natanggap ko na po yung admission form response nyo. So for the tuition fee po, if the student take 3 units, so for cash po, ang tuition po is 4,484.18 and then the miscellaneous is 6,773.31. So the total po for cash is 11,257.49. So for installment naman po, so ito po yung naka-flash, 5,156.81 and the total po is 12,946.12. So, ang payment schedule po nito is upon enrollment or upon registration po, they need to send 5,000 and then during midterms, pwede na po sila mag-send ng 4,000 and then for the third payment or the final term, 3,946. So, the for the total amount of 12,946. So, same with the, if they take 6 units, of course, madadagdagan lang po yung amount. Pero ganun din po yung process ng cash. And then kapag installment naman po, ganun pa rin po yung payment schedule. So upon enrollment, second payment is midterms, and then the third payment is for the final term. So ganun din po sa 9 units and the 12 units. So syempre ang pinagkaiba lang po is yung amount. Cash naman po dito. And isasend ko naman din po ito together with the student kit.
Hello, Ms. Tin.
Nawala.
Yeah, I think we lost your ano lang audio lang, Ms. Tin. Sorry.
Okay po. Parang hindi pa ako.
Okay na.
Okay na po.
Uh-oh.
So, saan po tayo nag-stop?
I think okay na din eh. Kasi you were saying okay that they will email you and then you can send all of this naman. But you don't have to memorize it at the moment, no? continuous naman ang communication between Christine and the student.
Yes, po. I-guide ko naman po sila step by step. Every step of the way. Yes, po.
Every step of the way. Nahawakan
yes, po.
Hold hands. Okay. Sino pa ang may question? Meron ako nakitang question na interested siya sa PR. Interested siya doon sa major in PR. If you're interested in that, meron kaming info session sa Friday at 4 o'clock. So, you can join that info session. Yan, involved din dyan si Wendell very closely dahil silang gumagawa ng mga magagandang art cards. So, Friday, 4 o'clock, mag-ano lang kayo ng antaw dyan. Ikiklik nila Ma'am Ollie yung ano, no? Yung invitation. Paano kaya? You will go to our Facebook page. Nandun naman yung ano, invitation to that info session. You click it para ma-enroll ka sa loob ng info session. And you can attend to find out more about the PR course. Okay? Are there any other questions?
Okay. I think Dr. Paz, si Alkin Firmo po ay may isa-throw na question live. So, ayan. So, nag-raise siya ng hand. So, baka pwede natin i-activate po ang mic niya, Miss Olly. So, again, yung pwede kayong mag-ask directly ng question. Ha? Ayan. Good morning, sir.
Yes, sir. Good morning. Alkin Firmo po ito. I'm calling from Zamboanga City po kasi. I was wondering po regarding po the new program that you have po. The public relations and corporate communications. But since it was already provided po yung information kanina that this would be this coming Friday, I'm already enlisted in that info session this coming Friday, Dr. Paz. So I'm looking forward to it. Another thing po pala, if ever the class is provided for of the Asian Institute of Journalism and Communication po. Is it completely online or would it be on blended learning? Because po, in other institutions as well, blended po kasi sila. So that's a question po that I would also like to throw in your good office. Po.
We have planned this first go as totally online.
Okay.
So the first batch will be totally online for the PR as well as for the MA in Com and MA in Journ. Okay, so
we're not yet
going into the blended format. Well, because we have also students who have enrolled from abroad pa nga eh.
Yes, ma'am.
So we have to maintain muna our online visibility.
Yes, ma'am. Clear, ma'am. Thank you so much for
Thank
that.
You.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much, Alkin, for that question. And of course, Dr. Paz. So who else has a question? Just kindly shoot it sa Q&A box natin or you can just directly ask our panelists. So that would be... Okay, another question again. Good day po, may I ask if ano usual schedule ng online classes po, weekday nights or Saturdays po? May I know if I can transfer since I'm waiting for the last day of summer class some math, technical English since I started the 9 units last June 2022. May ma-credit po kaya? By the way, I am a DSE English graduate.
Sandali, isa-isahin natin. Pwede ba nating i-show yung ano? Yung kaninang ginawa ko. We showed it na, no? Are you interested?
The call to action. Sir Eugene, kindly.
Can we show that first? I think that will...
Thank you.
That will answer. Yan. So if you're interested to proceed, so you send email to gs@aijc.com and we will send you the invitation letter that contains the courses offered, the fees, and the scheduled day and time for your classes. The classes are held from 6 to 9 every day, weekdays. So if your class is, for example, Mondays, 6 to 9, every Monday yon for 14 Mondays, 14 Mondays. Or kung Tuesday naman yung class mo, 6 to 9 then every Tuesday naman. Pag Saturdays, ang class mo, I think it's written there somewhere, from 9 to 12, isang class, from 1 to 4, second class, and then 5 to 8, the third class, 5 to 6, 7, 7, yeah, 3 hours per subject, that's it, per course. So after your entrance essay and interview, we send you the results and welcome you. Next, please. Then we will give you the pre-registration form in MS Forms. So that's by email lahat yan. Soft copy lahat yan. Tapos the pre-registration form response, merong conforme letter where you will affix your signature saying conforme to the payment schedules pati. And then based on your conforme letter, the registrar will create the registration card. And then we will have a copy. Okay, next please. And then these are the links for the MS forms. But we will send this to you as soon as you email us that you are interested. Kasi mahirap naman i-memorize lahat dyan. Okay, next please. Okay, so first you have to pass the entrance essay exam and interview. And then I have said already your completion of undergraduate. If you did an AB or BS, you may be required to take 12 units of journalism or communication subjects before starting the graduate degree course. We will assess first your undergrad transcript of records to see if you need pa or you can go directly na into the program itself. Next, please. Okay, official transcript of records, evidence. Now, for transferees, if you're transferring from one MA to the other, to us, you will have to earn 75% of your total number of units at AIJC. That is a CHED requirement. So you'll have to do more subjects at AIJC than at the school where you were previously enrolled. Okay, next please. This is again the same contact numbers. Was I able to answer your question? Sino ba ang nag-ask noon? Si Anonymous.
Anonymous. Okay. Ayan, yes, no, Dr. Paz.
Oh, okay.
Ayan. Thank you so much for asking those questions. I hope Dr. Paz is able to clear it
up. You can send us the email at gs@aijci. Don't forget the i, huh? .com. And we will send the materials to you.
Yes. So again, thank you so much, Dr. Paz, for answering the question and to our participant who just asked it. Any more question? Ayan, in one semester po, can we enroll lang a certain units, not full load?
Yeah, you can enroll lang 3 units if you like. 3 units lang kung medyo, you want, lalo na sa umpisa, you want to be not so burdened, isang subject. Pero yung iba nanghihinayang sa isang subject kasi ganun din ang babayaran mong miscellaneous. So yung iba nag-e-enroll ng 2 subjects, 6 units yun pag 2 subjects. Kasi ang 1 subject is 3 units, 1 course. Sa college at saka sa master's, we call it course. yung iba nag-try for courses, nag-give up. Masyadong mahirap. Kasi some professors really give heavy assignments.
Mm-hmm.
So, kailangan tansyahin mo. Ang tingin ko, two subjects to start with. Okay muna para matimplahan mo ang sarili mo. At the most three, kung masipag ka talaga at wala ka namang ibang ginagawa, dahil, minsan may profs na maraming magbigay ng assignments. So, and siyempre, meron tayong academic freedom. You have to please your prof also. So, yun. Ang nararamdaman kong nagda-drop ay pag-apat ang in-start. Pag-tatlo, may mangilan-milan pa ding nagda-drop. Pero pag-dalawa, parang okay. So you can start with two courses muna siguro sa first trimester. And then feel mo, kaya mo, dagdagan mo. Tapos dagdagan mo, itodo mo para kung namamadali ka, you want to graduate ka agad. Then itodo mo na. Okay.
Okay, thanks Dr. Paz. And I hope you answered it clearly for our attendee. And also, may nagtanong din Dr. Paz, no, how many units or courses are needed to finish the whole master's program?
39. The whole master's program is 39 units.
Only 39.
But it is less expensive than the master. It's more units, pero less expensive than the PR. The PR is double time, but higher ng konti ang fees kasi nagmamadali din ang students doon. So, law of demand and supply. Yung mga nagmamadali will have to invest more. Yung mga, ang MA income nila is medyo gradual. The investment is a little bit more normal. I think you saw our fees kanina, no? We flashed our fees. If you compare our fees with the fees of other graduate schools, I'm sure you will find our fees quite reasonable.
Yes, actually, Dr. Paz, that's quite right because I also tried to check other universities. And if you're getting the same quality education, I think AIJC can really, kayang-kaya natin eh. Kasi mas medyo mababa ng kaunti yung course fee natin. So I really hope na...
Hindi lang kaunti. Minsan doble.
medyo nag-humble lang tayo. Pero actually medyo malayo nga ang difference, Dr. Paz, sa totoo lang. Lalo na sa mga ibang prestigious schools talaga. So sana makapag-enroll po ang ating participants po.
We want to welcome our president. She's joining us already. Baka meron pang tanong.
Good morning, ayan. President Olive.
Hey,
last
everyone.
Question lang po. Yes. Last question before we proceed lang. What if hindi naman nagmamadali, ma'am, in PR? Sabi ni Alkin.
The promise is to finish in a certain period of time. That was our promise in PR. That's the difference. It's time sensitive.
15 months.
Tapos na kayo. That's the difference.
But you cannot. May question.
Oo. You get your diploma in shorter time, but the same quality of education.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you so much. If you still have questions, pwede nyo pa rin siyang i-shoot or pwede nyo itanong directly. Last question po, pwede po unahin muna tapusin ang MECOM before Jorn or vice versa po. Thanks po.
Ah, gusto mo pareho? Okay, eto. Sipag. Pwedeng,
sipag.
Sipag. Pwedeng kahit unahin mo. Kahit mag-una ka ng Jorn muna, pagkatapos na mag-enroll ka sa form, iniisip ko I will have to check the units kasi if nakuha mo na yung mga required units, baka ang kakailanganin mo na lang are the major.
Yes.
Tama ka. You will have two majors within siguro 2 years or 3 years.
Ayan, double major.
Double. Oh, okay.
Very, that's very good. May premium yan.
Pero Dr. Paz, President Olive, what would be the standard piece of advice if, for example, I have the same question then? What if I want to ipagsabay yung dalawang program na yun? So what would be your advice? Should I take the journalism first or the communication? What would be your take on that?
Depends.
Yeah.
It's up to doesn't matter, no?
Kung journalist ka, syempre, unahin mong MA in journalism. Tapos ituloy mo sa com.
All right. So regardless pala, there's no difference.
Doesn't matter.
Okay. So thank you so much again, President Olive and Dr. Paz, for answering that question. And ito na, nauna nang pumasok ang ating president, hindi pa natin nai-introduce. Ito ang susunod na speaker natin.
To just welcome
the students. Again, i-claim ko na na-enrollin na sila in the future. Ang pinaka-sweet, isa sa pinaka-sweet. And
you're so sweet.
Okay, so let's welcome our president, our beloved President Olive Villafuerte.
You know, I'd like to say, my dear students, ang sarap sabihin eh, di ba? I'm welcoming. I have been asked to welcome you this morning, but strangely enough, this welcome message comes at the end of the program. But yeah, it's okay, I'm welcoming you at the end of the program. So therefore, let me welcome you, dear students, AIJC. Yes, you have learned all about AIJC at the start of the program, a 40-year-old, 40 lang, pero marami nang na-achieve. An institution that has been known as a knowledge center for communication and journalism. You have heard from our Vice President for Academics and our Dean for the Graduate School, ladies and gentlemen, the iconic Dr. Paz Hernandez Diaz, whose name has been synonymous with communication education. You've heard about the academic calendar and the curriculum. He has also answered your questions. Dr. Paz has explained to you the two programs, the programs of the Master of Arts in Communication, Master of Arts in Journalism. Now, as you enroll in these programs, you will receive lessons, teachings and learning from our faculty, many of who have received their education and training from AIJC. We also have experts and specialists in the communication field from different top communication institutions, all bearing the brand that is AIJC. Journalism and communications are two separate different programs, but related to each other. So you may take one after the other. As somebody, I think, asked earlier. See, at AIJC, we go out of our way to know you. We'd like to know you, our students, to identify with you as we guide you through your education here at AIJC. We'll see you through your stay here. That's a promise. We will lead you on to your comprehensive exams and your thesis defense, and ensure that you earn rightly and receive your diploma. So what you saw at the start, the entrance exam and the interview, fear not, do not be intimidated by this. This is our way of getting to know you. That's why we have the exam and the interview. We want to know you better before you come into AIJC. And again, and Wendell knows this, and Dr. Paz, my favorite line to you as I close this program. Dr. Paz will hold your hand, both hands, kung pwede lang, di ba, Dr. Paz, and lead to and guide you. I will hold your heart with both hands, if necessary, and see you through your AIJC education. So welcome again, students. See you all in class, because I sit in on the class. So I hope to see all of you in our class. Thank you.
Thank you so
much. There you have it. Thank you so much, President Olive. And again, yun na nga, in AIJC, we will hold your hands and we will hold your heart. So that's a testament. Yes. With two hands, if possible, if physically possible, why not? So it just goes to show that here in AIJC, you're not just studying and working with, you know, facilitators and faculty members. You're working and studying with humans with heart and soul who will guide you all the way hanggang sa makagraduate kayo. So thank you so much, Dr. Paz and President Olive.
Thank you.
And Sir Eugene, can we flash lang sa screen yung ating social media, lahat yung email natin para makita ng ating participants so they can screenshot it?
Pagkatapos, they can email.
Yes. So this is our contact details. So if you have further questions, you can just send your queries at gs@aijci.com. So don't forget the I, it's very important. And we also have, of course, Facebook page. It's at AIJCMLA. Or you can just simply type in AIJC Manila or AIJC and nakikita nyo agad. Marami kaming information na pinopost doon. So, nabanggit nga kanina, we have an upcoming PR info session on Friday. Although I won't be there, so Dr. Paz will be and of course, President Olive and all the stakeholders from the PRST. Napaka-insightful noon and bagong-bago yun. So, I hope you guys are excited for that. And ayun, we will also send you an email. So from time to time, mag-email blast kami.
We have their email addresses naman, di ba?
Yes, Dr. Paz, in our database. So worry not because you'll be updated every now and then. Yes, regarding our programs and courses and everything that you need to know about AIJC. So again, to our participants, good morning and thank you so much. I'm just really happy, genuinely happy that we're able to gather this much number today kahit na medyo maulan and interactive tong session na to. So maraming salamat. Ms. Team, do you have any last message to our participants?
Thank you everyone for joining us today. So we are so glad and we are hoping that you learned about our program and I hope you might consider enrolling to AIJC.
Yes, and we are claiming na, as I was saying kanina, we are claiming na students na sila kasi mag-enroll na.
Understood na yun.
Yes. So again, thank you so much to our participants. I hope you have a great day. Thank you so much to our panelists, Dr. Paz Diaz, President Olive, Ms. Dean, and all the people behind
thank the
camera.
So thank IT. You so much. Thank you for the IT support, Ms.
Thank
Paul.
You, Sir Eugene.
Eugene, Ollie,
thank you
Eugene.
So much.
Ma'am Ollie.
And thank you to our participants. Good morning.
Morning. Magpipicture tayo. That is... Meron tayong participant na kapampangan, Dakal, salamat po.